30 years ago, I watched war games on the telly. And the very next day, I bought my first computer, and here we are. I think there's a pretty dramatic shift going on in how software is being delivered. So it used to be, certainly over the last almost half century, that software would assist you in doing a job a little bit faster and a little bit more accurate. This new paradigm, which is about to arrive, is one for where you describe what you want done, then the software will do that for you.
I think we are still learning how to interact with machines that are not on glass, right? Like that, how do you talk to a machine? How do you write to a machine? What is the expectation? I think our interaction with other software like Siri, Amazon Echo, certainly educating the community, but I think we're still very, very early on.
We schedule meetings, and that means we've created this intelligent agent that can schedule meetings and go negotiate on your behalf. So that once you CC her in, her first task is to remove you from the conversation, have this very human-like dialogue back and forth with one or more participants, understand exactly what the constraints are, what your preferences look like, and negotiate that to end, understand what's concluded, and upon conclusion, send all the participants an invite.
I really want to eliminate all of the mundane tasks that I have to do, whether it's scheduling or travel, making travel reservations or data entry, anything. I want to get rid of all of those tasks so I can focus on just really high value tasks. So I think as AI gets better, most of those tasks should be able to be automated.
Which is the optimistic version of where I think we're headed, which is not mass unemployment. No, just mass focus. If you want to be a good designer, you should do that 95% of your time, not all the other shit you do, to really do your job.
I think the Bay Area, because you have all of the tech pedigree and all of the developers out there, people sometimes just focus on technology for technology's sake. You just build it because it's cool and you can. And in New York, I think just the nature, we've always been a commercial center, so we always think about like what's the practical application of the technology, how do you monetize it.
I think there is something magical about New York, that being able to, it's much easier to convince someone from Chicago or Philly or Boston, who many of them are here, to move to Manhattan versus going somewhere else.
I'm making a good barter, which is that I'll most certainly pay more for my engineers here versus me having started the venture in Utah. But I do also get something in return, which is that there's people which I can only hire here. Then I also like that the community is hungry enough to try to be the next Silicon Valley, for where they want us all to succeed so we can stick it to those fuckers out west. And that, I think, breeds a good attitude in the city.